Hey everyone, thank you for joining me on our YouTube channel, Flippin' Hippos. I'm Star. Hey, if you're new here or you have not already, please consider subscribing to the channel and helping us feed a hungry hippo. And don't forget to hit that thumbs up button as you're listening today. Today, we're taking a look at jeans that sold on eBay in the month of May. I haven't pulled up every single pair of jeans that sold in the month of May. We'd be here all day. And also, we sell a lot of the same brands consistently over and over again. So I'm not going to show you 15 different pairs of American Eagles and 20 Old Navies. We can look at one pair and talk about why they're a good bread and butter brand, and suffice it that that's enough. However, I did go on my list perfectly and... filter my catalog to sold, eBay, with jeans in the title. You can see my search parameters up here. So we can go down to May. You see where the dates are, where it sold. This is when I marked it sold in the catalog. And we can just kind of scroll down through all these jeans in May. And you can see it's a lot of the same brands. There's some poop ones that we clearanced out. But generally speaking, we sell the same brands over and over again. Why? Because they're tried and true bread and butter brands. Most of you know by now our cost of goods is typically 99 cents. So I get the same things for 99 cents every time I go out thrifting. I do get a lot of the thread up denim rescue boxes. I just did an unboxing last week. So I'll have that pop up at the end of this video for you, and you can go watch that if you'd like. And that's how I get new to me and different brands, is through those thread up boxes. Side note, real quick, before we get into the jeans, I do love that on List Perfectly, I can go in my catalog and sort very easily by sold, what platform it's sold on. I can look for specific jeans or plush. It's how I get organized for a lot of these what sold videos. It's how a lot of my friends do their bookkeeping and their accounting. List Perfectly is a lot more than just a cross-posting service. I am recording brand new, up-to-date 2023 tutorial videos in a List Perfectly playlist. I'll have that pop up at the end for you also, if you're interested, just to show you all of the things that you can do with List Perfectly above and beyond cross-posting. And don't forget, you can try it for 30% off your first month with code FLIPPINHIPPOS, with no contract, with no obligation. You try it for 30% off. If you don't like it, you cancel, and there's no penalties. Code Flippin' Hippos. All right, let's jump into the jeans. Chicos. I used to source Chicos like I had stock in the company. I used to think this was like, oh, it's the brand to grab, and I would source it all the time. I kind of avoid it nowadays, with some exceptions to the rule. I do like the Chicos So Slimming and the Chicos So Lifting. And the Chicos women's blouses and jackets, like fashion jackets and blazers, those do really well also. But even for 99 cents most of the time, I'll pass up Chicos that aren't the So Slimming or the So Lifting. You can see that they sell for over $20, but they sit for a very long time. The slimming and lifting ones have a higher sell-through rate and sell a little more quickly. That's the case with any brand. If they're slimming, lifting, tucking, booty shaping, if they do anything to make a woman look slimmer, shaped, those are definitely something you want to source. Chicos So Slimming, So Lifting, Not Your Daughter's Jeans, Democracy, Ab Technology, Want a Better Butt jeans, the But I Love You jeans. There's so many out there. If they say slimming or lifting or tuck or anything like that, they're definitely a bolo. American Eagle is one of my favorite, tried and true. In fact, my trifecta of favorite bread and butters at current are American Eagle, Old Navy, and Gap. Men's jeans are going to sell more quickly and for more money than women's, but I grab them all when I find them for 99 cents. These are the men's Airflex jeans. I pulled these up specifically to show you this tag, the next level Airflex. I grab these and I can ask for a little bit more money. I usually start these around 27 and then they can go on sale and I still have wiggle room. JMS, solid plus size bread and butter brand. JMS stands for just my size. This was a brand you could find at Kmart. Has a solid customer following, a loyal base of women who have worn these, find them to be comfortable, and would like to continue wearing them and can't find them anywhere. So they go online to shop for them. I would generally say that any plus size jeans, especially if you have in your area, not even if you don't have a 99 cents day, but if you have like a $2 day at your thrift, grab all the plus size jeans. I can even flip Faded Glory, which is Walmart brand, plus size jeans for $20 and $25, and they'll usually sell within a week of going up. Plus sizes do really well. Abercrombie & Fitch and Hollister. I'll mention Hollister here. Here's a pair of Hollister I can show you. A lot of folks will avoid these two mall brands. They think they're poop. I mean, I sell them for $18 to $25 all day long, every day. They sell more quickly than other brands. They sell reliably. They don't take that long. Abercrombie and Hollister are usually going to be smaller sizes, like juniors or the zero sizes. So they're going to ship first class. So when I find them for 99 cents, I always grab these two brands, always, because they're going to be a quick return on my investment. They're going to cost me less to ship. They take up less space to store because they're smaller, but they're also the other end of the spectrum of the plus size. So any of those mid sizes, those are easy to find. Those are oversaturated. Those are everywhere. Women who wear plus sizes do have a difficult time finding clothing that fits them well, that they find to be comfortable, that are brands and styles that they will buy time and again. But then you have the other side. Women who wear junior sizes or the zero or double zeros, those sizes are hard to find too, believe it or not. The really small and the plus size are both harder to find. Those are the sizes women come online to shop for. White House Black Market. I typically avoid these now also. Even for 99 cents, I will leave the majority of this brand behind on the racks, unfortunately. When I first started reselling, this was a brand I would always grab. It was kind of sought after. It was a little more higher end. It's unfortunately fallen out of popularity. It's been a victim of the race to the bottom. It's just very oversaturated and the sell-through rate is very slow. However, there's exceptions to every rule. So if I saw a pair of White House Black Market jeans that were very unique, very cute, had a great style, a larger size. If they come out of a thrift box, I mean, you know, there's always exceptions to the rule. So I don't say no to these all the time, but generally speaking, yes, avoid this brand anymore. If you have a better experience with it than I do, you can let me know in the comments. I mean, these did sell for $24.99. So, I mean, that's nothing to sneeze at for a 99 cent pair of jeans, right? Current Elliott, this is a brand you want to look for. I can typically sell it for 25 to 30 bucks, depending if I do a sale or best offers. These are the stiletto Kohl's, which we did not put in the title. Shame on us. Well, there you go. Now you can learn from one of our mistakes today. If you have something on the tag like this, you want to put it in the title. So this really should have been Current Elliott Stiletto Kohl Jeans, women's size, and so on. This is what the tag looks like. You do want to look for these. Seven for All Mankind. I like this brand. The Dojos are the bolos. They'll have sevens on the back pocket, and they will say Dojo, D-O-J-O, in the waistband here. They'll sell for around $60, maybe a little more on Poshmark. Anything that's not the Dojos is going to be solid bread and butter that you're going to get between 25 to 35, depending on size and style. Here's one of my trifectas. This is Old Navy all day long. I start my women's at 20, my men's at 25. I go up from there if it's a plus size, if it has a button fly, if it has something special about it, like these American Eagles with this next level Airflex. I'll add a couple bucks in for those things, for those special specifics. Taylor Vintage. So this is new to me. They came in a throwout box. And I will now be sourcing these when I find them. These are men's. Size 32, 32. I did take a best offer on these, a 25. Still pretty good. So I will always look for these, especially on 99 cent day. They have a little pair of scissors there. You can see the tag. Another pair of American Eagle. Obviously, these are men's Airflex. So we started them at the $26.99. Men's are always going to go for a little more and sell a little quicker than women's. It just is. And some Levi's 550. These are boys. So these aren't even adult jeans. These are kids' jeans that sold for $18 or $17.99 to be specific. I don't source kids' clothes as a general rule, but when they come to me in thread up boxes, I list them all day long. And sometimes when I'm at the thrift, kids' jeans will be accidentally put in on the racks with the women's and the men's jeans. And if I find something like this where I know it's a Levi's 550, I'm going to get 18 for, I'll grab them for 99 cents, even though they're kids, because that's the same return on investment I'm getting from Hollister's that I sell for 18 that I get for 99 cents. So it's like the same concept. I don't go to the kids section and go out of my way, but if I find them or they find their way to me in a wholesale, absolutely, especially with Levi's and some of the higher end jeans brands, even the kids can sell for a good amount. If you have any questions, comments, concerns about anything you saw in this video today, about jeans or reselling in general, leave a comment below or join my Facebook group, Flippin' Hippos Reseller Pod, and you can ask all the questions you want in there. Everyone in there is super nice and super helpful. If you want more details on specifics of cost of goods and how these items shipped and best offers I accepted, I do a series on this channel every Monday. What sold on eBay? But in these monthly videos where I'm just focusing on jeans, I try to just talk more about each brand or style and why or why not it is a good item to source. Go be productive, guys. Go make some money. And as always, thank you so, so much for watching. Y'all are the best. Bye.